Lead poisoning. Would you like lead in your consumables? Well, there are 7 products that are recalled by the FDA because of lead poisoning. I'm a pharmacist. Welcome to Track MTM. It's scary because when I opened up the website, the first thing that popped up is a bunch of recalls, of course, and there are so many different companies with around the same product line that has FDA recall, and it's hitting all of these companies. I actually had to make a spreadsheet just so I can make sure I include all the information for you guys. Well, first of all, it's a candy by the brand Tolteca. And it has Saladitos Dry Salted Plum, okay? That's the main thing that's being recalled here. So if you like plum candy, don't eat these. And it's the ones with con chile y limon, which is chile and lime. Basically, it's recalling the 1.5 ounce packages of these dried salted plums because of potential contaminated with lead. Lead, we all know, is a toxic substance present in our environment, like small amounts exposed to like a daily actions. Like let's say you inhale some dust, eating kind of food, drinking water, etc. So if you consume too much, it's gonna cause lead poisoning. Symptoms include abdominal pain, vomiting, irritable, weakness, behavioral mood changes, delirium, seizures, and coma even. So especially the youngins, like the infants, young children, especially the developing fetus, can be affected with chronic exposure to amounts of lead that might result in obvious symptoms of like lead poisoning. A child, let's say, with lead poisoning may not look sick, but trust me, like it has long-term effects like learning disabilities, developmental delays, and lower IQ scores, okay? You want your child to be smart, don't let them consume lead. Simple, right? Another brand we're talking about is American Gourmet. Again, Saladito Dry Salted Plum. This one in the 99 cents bag, again, 1.5 ounce. Same deal, lead poisoning. Ugh, scary. Lead toxicity can be serious and you can be hospitalized too. Next company is Rojas with the brand name of Lupag, plain dry salted plum. This company is actually in Los Angeles, California. Again, lead poisoning with production date of December 2021. They always say no illnesses have been reported to date, but you know, it's gonna cause long-term problems. Like, you don't want to wait until you find out later on, right? Next company is, or the brand is El Leoncito, El Super Leon Brands, with the product Saladitos Salted Dry Plum with and without chile. Oh, this one is product of San Diego, California. Same deal, no illnesses have been found. Next company is A&E Corrales with the spice and chili brand name. Product description, Saladitos Dry Salted Plum with chili this time. And this is actually a Seattle, Washington brand. In the 16 ounce bag, so like a 1 pounder. Next one, brand name, La Fiesta Food Products with Saladitos con Chile. Product description with spice, yeah. Distributed to retail stores from December 1st to through January 31st. The thing that's scaring me the most is the lower IQ score. Let's just maybe not with children alone, but like, let's see, adults, would you want like lower IQ score for an adult? I mean, I wouldn't, so I wouldn't consume these products. Next one, brand name El Chavito. Product description, Saladitos Dry Plums with and without chile. Product of San Diego, California, again, from January 9th, 2019 to February 2nd, 2022. Wow, that's like at least maybe 3 years time frame. Wow, this brand has quite a scary. It's in the 1.7 ounce. If you consume something with this brand, it doesn't just go back of December, but it goes back 3 years ago. And you've had lead all this time? And you've had lead in your system all this time without knowing? And it took them 3 years to figure it out. I'm scared. Well, that's it. That's all on my list. I mean, it's not much, just 7 different brands. And hey, one of them happened to have a 3-year time span. So if you consume anything like this, and if you're concerned, I would contact your doctor, make sure you get like lab tests and stuff, make sure like you're not over the limit in terms of like lead ingestion, and like make sure you're not at the toxicity level. And like I said earlier, there are like signs and symptoms that you can kind of gauge if you have lead poisoning. Okay, it can be serious, so please take it seriously. All right, you guys have a wonderful day and stay safe. Bye bye.